Hi, this is Dain from the loadUI team. In this video, we're going to take a look at server monitoring in loadUI. Now, server monitoring is specific to loadUI Pro, but head on over to loadui.org and you can download a 14-day free trial. So let's get started.
To showcase server monitoring, I've created a basic load test here, sending 10 requests per second to a web server running on a remote computer. And let's add some server monitors. So to do that, we'll go into the statistics workbench. Server monitors are added using the monitors tab, which is located down at the bottom. So let's open that up. As you can see on the left here, we have a bunch of different categories for monitors. As my web server is running IIS, we'll add a monitor for that. So I'll just type in the IP address. And test to make sure that connection is working. We can also add another monitor. I'll use a Windows monitor since I'm running Windows on that server. Alright, once these monitors have been added, we can close this panel. And we see that a new group has been created in the statistics toolbar here called monitors. And it has both of our added monitors. So let's add these to a couple of charts here. So the Windows monitor is going to show the CPU usage and the available memory on the remote machine, and those are pretty much going to be stable throughout this test. Looking at the IIS side, let's get rid of these statistics and add some new ones of our own. So I'm going to add bytes total per second for the default website. So that should correspond very well with the load we're actually sending against it. I mean, it's the network traffic, so we should have a very strong correlation there. I'm also going to add the web page runner to this existing chart. And by default, that adds time taken and transactions per second. So let's start this test and see what happens. All right, the test is now running. Let's switch back to the statistics workbench. And here we can see that we're getting some lines. This red one has some very high values. So let's change the scale of that. That's bytes total, in actual bytes. So we can move that down a bit. There we go. So this is pretty much steady here. We see that the network traffic is stable, the throughput is stable. So if I increase the rate at which we're sending requests here, we should see something happen here. All right. So the TPS jumps, which is pretty natural, that corresponds tightly to this number here. That's what the actual client is getting in throughput. But we also see that the server is reporting that network traffic also jumps very closely to this. So this, of course, is what we would be expecting. And this gives us a way to actually see what's happening on the server as it's happening and ties in together with what's happening on the client as well. Unfortunately, as I said, the CPU and memory are pretty much unaffected in this test. But if there's a problem on the server, this would definitely come in handy showing us what's really going on. As with our component framework, it's really easy to extend monitors by creating your own ones. With a bit of Groovy scripting, you can create custom monitors. So let's look at this monitor that I've created called simply my monitor. I'll add it to the localhost. Of course, this is just a dummy page. And we can add that. Let's do a new page. There we go. And add that to the charts. Yeah, and as you can see, this is just showing a sine wave, basically. But this allows you to monitor pretty much anything on your server that you can get access to, allowing you to extend this to really cover all your needs. And that's server monitor.